the river was the most important way of traveling back and forth. Well, then immigration started, and when they brought the immigrants in, they said, you have to build a road across your property joining your neighbors. So people built maybe one road this way, the neighbor built here, you did this on the property line, you really strange roads, but they're roads. Then in 50, my husband said, Captain Jocelyn, he said, look, we're going to take the front door and we're going to move it there because that's where all our traffic is coming from, all our trade. And when he did that, he discovered something called a stove. When you go in that part of my house, you'll see an addition. And he built that to accommodate the stove. Now we are warm in the winter because we close the door and the stove heats that part of the house. It heats the bedrooms upstairs. There's a hole in my ceiling in my workroom, and we take the board off and the heat goes up there and we are warm. Mm-hmm. So when you go in there, I've had that stove now for 10 years. It's my pride and joy. And the other thing you'll notice when you go into my workroom, I have a quilt on and it's made of cotton. Now, I'm not sure if you realize how important that is. Because for me, every bit of fabric in my house, when I was younger, raising my family, I had to make every bit of fabric. So I had to grow flax, rot it, beat it, take it and spin it, and then weave it into linen. And to make a simple bed sheet took me 2 weeks to weave with all the other work that I have to do. My husband came home with cotton. It's one great big piece. I just have to hem it. So this is amazing. Even my clothing is made out of cotton. I don't have to wear wool in the summer anymore. So when you go through and see those things, you'll realize, you know, how things have improved for me. And I absolutely love it. So you get to enjoy it. And you can go upstairs if you like, and you can go through the house if you like. Adelaide is in the kitchen. She's our servant girl. She's been farmed out. What they do, see, most people have 10, 13, 16 children. You must have had, what, 18 children maybe? So what happens when the older ones are eating more than they produce? Mm-hmm. Then you farm them out to your neighbors, people like us whose children have grown. And we pay Adelaide one Spanish dollar a week, and she works 7 days a week. And it's a Spanish dollar because right now, in the United States, they're just now making something called an American dollar, but we're still using a Spanish dollar. And we deal with that with Canada, we pay them in pounds, and now there's something being made called a New Brunswick dollar. So it's easier for us just to pay her in a Spanish dollar. If she ever goes to New York, she can buy whatever she wants. Highly unlikely, but you know, her family will probably use the money instead. But she's been farmed out. But her father